Good day to you from ChemHelp ASAP. This video will cover a bit more difficult addition reaction sequence. Our starting material is on the left and our product is on the right. This is strange because it looks like two groups have been added to our carbonyl. That's impossible. You can only add one group to a carbonyl because a carbonyl has only one pi bond. Instead of fully analyzing this problem before we start, let's just start and see what we can do. The product alcohol has two new groups, a methyl and an ethyl. Let's go ahead and add one of these groups, let's say the methyl, and then see what we can do after that. React our starting material with a methyl organometallic. Let's do an organolithium. So that's CH3Li. In total, this will require two steps. First, we'll make the tetrahedral intermediate, which we won't show, and then protonate it with water. Here is our new alcohol. We're not done, but at least we've added the methyl. How can we also add the ethyl? It would be easy if only the alcohol were a carbonyl. Well then, let's just oxidize the alcohol to a carbonyl, a ketone in this case. We can do that. There are lots of possible reagents. The Swern oxidation is a personal favorite of mine. We can just write Swern over the arrow. If you want to get fancy, you can write Swern oxidation. That gives us a new carbonyl, so we get a fresh carbon-oxygen pi bond. We'll perform a nucleophilic addition with an ethyl organometallic, ethyl magnesium bromide. Let's use the Grignard this time. Followed by water in a second step to give our final desired alcohol. In this transformation, we wanted to perform two nucleophilic additions. That's fine, but we need to oxidize the intermediate alcohol product before we could move forward with the second addition.